History has told us that innovation doesn't happen in a vacuum. There's an inspiration, a spark. And in 1915, Albert Einstein lit a fire under the world of physics. Einstein's theories of general relativity and special relativity became the law of the land for both aspiring physicists and experienced scholars. A so-called theory of everything was now seen as a possibility through the lens of the theory of relativity, and discovering the universal answer to the cosmos would become the ultimate goal of each of the following generations of physicists. In 1962, one such extraordinary young physicist would be accepted into Cambridge for a Ph.D. in cosmology. Stephen Hawking was determined to find the answer. Hawking excelled in his academics from a young age and would go on to provide his own groundbreaking theories on black holes and cosmology, rivaling the successes of even Einstein. Established physicists in the 60s had become complacent with the discoveries of the early 20th century, and the world of science had become a hostile place for ideas that challenged traditional notions. Hawking pushed back against these outdated notions, introducing revolutionary concepts of the logistics of black holes, the mechanics of space-time, and the creation of the universe. Hawking began attending Trinity Hall at the University of Cambridge in 1962, after graduating with honors from the University of Oxford. Despite his father's hopes that Stephen would pursue a medical degree, he started on his journey to a Ph.D. in cosmology. Space fascinated Hawking. He was constantly lost in his own thoughts, calculating and theorizing, trying to put together pieces of the puzzle. In 1963, he faced a potentially fatal dilemma. Hawking had been diagnosed with ALS, a motor neuron disease. The diagnosis distressed Stephen, but given only 2 years to live, it in turn propelled him to dive more vigorously into his studies. Stephen's Cambridge supervisor, Dennis Sciama, greatly supported his work and helped Stephen navigate the bureaucratic side of physics, providing a platform for his unconventional ideas. 3 years later, he presented his doctoral thesis to Sciama and astrophysicist Fred Hoyle. The thesis wasn't perfect. It was as good as you could hope for from a slacking doctorate student. But Sciama and Hoyle were fascinated. It introduced a revolutionary concept that would run a thread through some of his most revolutionary work. Hawking theorized that the universe started with a singularity. A singularity may be a familiar concept to some. A singularity is the core of a black hole. It is what forms from a collapsed star, creating an incredibly massive and concentrated anomaly that bends space-time to its breaking point. Hawking was among very few theoretical physicists to believe that time comes to a stop at this point. Hawking suggested that if the Big Bang was the beginning of time, could a singularity be precisely the anomaly necessary to create the universe as we know it? For Hawking to base his thesis around black holes was not only groundbreaking in its application to the Big Bang, but was a huge risk to take for credibility reasons. Black holes were considered science fiction at the time. In fact, they had yet to receive their iconic name, instead referred to as frozen stars. Hawking's breakthroughs on black holes didn't stop there. In 1974, Hawking introduced the idea that black holes emit thermal radiation, which was so influential that the phenomenon was aptly named Hawking radiation. Along with theoretical physicist Jacob Bekenstein, Hawking recognized that the second law of thermodynamics required that a black hole have entropy, but that this law could be violated if mass was added. Hawking radiation allowed, for the first time, the ideas of entropy and the second law of thermodynamics to apply to previously held beliefs on black holes. Hawking's ideas weren't free from criticism, including his own. He recognized that trying to answer such existential questions would result in failure sometimes. In order to answer the question, what happened before the universe, Hawking had to completely reevaluate his singularity theory presented in his doctorate thesis. Physicists at the time had been groping for what happened during the Big Bang and where the energy came from. Hawking and friend James Hardle developed the No Boundary Proposal in 1983, which predicted that the universe didn't begin from a point, but rather expanded from a curved area, resembling a shuttlecock, where the bottommost point would have a diameter of zero. The implications of this proposal were that the universe had no beginning, no boundary for time at all. The Hardle-Hawking state is still widely debated among physicists today, but whether or not Hawking was correct, it is still regarded to be one of the most visionary ideas on the topic to date, not only breaking the barriers of time, but completely removing them. Despite the controversy surrounding the Hardle-Hawking proposal, Hawking's so-called information paradox was, according to him, his greatest blunder. The commonly held notion pre-Hawking was that black holes retained the information of particles. Like energy, the laws of physics state that information is conserved. This idea had its roots in time dilation, which suggested that, since the immense gravity of a black hole distorted time, an object entering one would appear to slow down and eventually disappear long after it was destroyed. Hawking radiation, however, implied the destruction and loss of information, thus an information paradox. Controversy surrounding Hawking as a figure has swirled about for decades, continuing past his death. His theories came from a place of curiosity, a yearning to know the answer, and many physicists criticized him for this, saying that he was too quick to pass judgment, resulting in faulty or incomplete ideas. Many physicists cited the information paradox. Many resented him for his persona he had undoubtedly created. But he wasn't afraid of being wrong, always embracing the newest and boldest ideas. His final theory, A Smooth Exit from Eternal Inflation, was published as recently as 2017 and spoke on 21st century concepts of string theory and holographic theory. Hawking pushed the boundaries of physics, occasionally in moments of genius, breaking the boundaries, and occasionally stumbling over them. Stephen was merely a man, constrained by society and by nature, yet he had an infinite imagination that drew people to him, a singularity in his own right.
Just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving and revolving at 900 miles an hour. That's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned. The sun that is the source of...